not slow, and one came in pretty close. I got ready to be turned off, but another one came just in. Out of breath. Another one came in close, and I just went.
Do you have all three bands powered? Or
finally,
four or three?
I only got three.
You only got three.
So you had all
I barely get was able to cock them.
Oh, no, wait a minute. I thought he was about an 80-pound fish, and he was down below me, and I was about 30 feet down, so he was probably 50 feet down. He, fortunately, he was down below me, and the momentum of the shaft would carry better.
Oh, did he need a hand?
Did he fight?
He's like,
trying to follow him?
My white buoy is down 30 feet, going through the water, and I'm kicking on the surface trying to keep so I wouldn't lose sight of it.
He gave me the other gun, and I swam down about 50 feet. And he turned sideways, and I go, and shot him, and blood just goes flying out of both sides. I mean, that was really hurt him. And then Steve goes, choop, and the other shaft pulled out, just like that.
Wow.
Just that time, that's the second.
Thank you.
it looked like they were a couple hundred pounds, and then I saw one swing into the right of me down below me. I shot, hit the fish, and the next thing I knew, my 150 to 200 feet of line plus my buoys were skipping along underneath the water about 50 feet. I chased them just so that they wouldn't get out of my sight. They finally, the top ones came to the surface, and I hung onto it for about a half an hour, and then Steve and the boat showed up. Steve got in the water and helped me, and after about another 45 minutes of the fish swimming around down about 200 feet, we were able to pull him up to within about 50 feet of the surface. Steve handed me his gun. I swam down and put another shaft in him, and then killed him. That's the story. While Steve and I were waiting for the fish to tire himself out so that we could bring him to the surface enough to get a second shaft in him, a school of dolphins came in on us, and we were real worried that they were going to do something to the fish steering or whatever so that he'd get off the shaft. When I did put the second shaft in him, I knew I had him then because the blood spurted out of both sides of him. But the minute I hit him, the first shaft came out, and I'd have lost the fish if he'd have taken off again before that second shaft went in. We pulled him up to the surface, and Bob Marks and the fella in the boat helped me get him in, and we brought him back to the big boat.
All the way back, hoping that everything runs, hoping you don't run out of fuel, hoping we don't see any great white sharks, hoping the water's clear. Let's change the name to Hope Island.
Because there's no guarantees at Guadalupe.
There's no guarantee at Guadalupe or any others, but especially at Guadalupe.
But if the conditions are right.
And if the conditions are right, probably the most thrilling trip of your diving life.
In all the years and all the islands you've been to, would you say it's one of the more exciting places?
Yes, by all means. And the other comment that I could make is it's we've never had it dirty there. We've always had clear water. Now that